It's a joke.
It's our favorite. Yeah, and he's gonna say jam. I don't even know these. What? I don't know how I got it. But like, I think Joey had told me. That's like 200 yen.
No, this is a Catholic sermon.
I didn't take down the grilled cheese. Somebody else.
I thought you were reading for
me. No.
Everybody leaving. Everybody leaving. Hey. Okay, it's good.
Oh, yeah, I bring
it up. Come on, Joe, smile.
Oh, there's
another one.
like to invite Joe Rubik up to welcome us in.
To bless their marriage, their family, and all their relationships, help them stay strong in any challenges they may face, and to treasure and protect the joy of marriage. May we, as their family and friends, commit to uphold and encourage them to the best of our ability. Please bless this food we are about to receive, and let this reception be an honor to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
She started to give herself timeouts. She'd be kids are looking at each other like, what just happened? And then you have a poor attitude. So, I mean, that's not normal, that's just weird. And then, as a child, she'd have these strange phobias that would pop up every once in a while, like come out of nowhere. Like one summer, she became afraid of ants. So literally walking on the sidewalk was a scary thing for her. And then there was the fear of clouds. Literally, a little wisp of cloud, she wouldn't go outside. So that was kind of an odd thing. So we had a few challenges raising her. And as she became a teenager, most parents probably have this conversation amongst themselves, but you wonder, hey, is my kid ever going to grow up enough where they'll actually move out? Has anybody ever had that conversation? I mean, you know, you start becoming kind of nervous because, yeah, they're good kids, but they're not ready to take on the world yet. And Duran seemed to be a little bit more nervous about that than a lot of kids. But you fix that real quick. When she got into college, she was living on campus at Marquette, and she began to do a number of different internships. Go Warriors, right? So these internships that she'd do, she was an engineering student, and she'd go and live in different parts of the country for anywhere from 2 to 4 months. And she rotated around North Carolina, Connecticut, Illinois, Springfield, Illinois. And over those trips, some of them worked out really well. She was happy, some she struggled quite a bit. And we watched her grow into a very confident young lady who could take care of herself. And that was just a neat thing to see. A lot of fun to watch. When she got done with college, she wound up in Louisville, and she was working on, at that time, it was one of the biggest construction projects. They put 2 new bridges over the Ohio River in Louisville, and they extended the freeway. It was a huge, massive project. So here we are with Pat and I going down here to visit with her, and she said, hey, I'll take you guys on to the construction site. So we said, yeah, okay, let's go check it out. So we climb into this F-150 truck, and it's covered with dust. It's a white truck, just covered with dust. We all had to wear helmets because we were going to be on construction helmets. So we're sitting in this truck covered with dust. I've never been in such a dirty vehicle. And my daughter, who's about this tall, jumps into the driver's seat. I swear she had to have at least one phone book on the seat so she could see what the truck. And we're driving and we're going through this construction site. And it's, I mean, there was like rocks and dust and dirt everywhere, these huge earth-moving trucks and vehicles that were going all over the place. And here's my daughter driving down huge steep declines and inclines. And Ben, I'm looking at this, and you got these guys, the big macho guys looking at her and waving at her like she was the boss. And I'm thinking, how does my daughter, who's afraid of ants and clouds, end up driving through this? And she's like, yeah, over there they're going to be blasting with dynamite. You got to make sure that they're not doing it right now. I'm like, oh my God. So Joanna came a long way, and we were very proud of her, how much she accomplished and where she came growing as an individual. And she eventually wound up back in Milwaukee, and she started dating this guy named Jeff. Well, my daughter, again, being a mama's girl, she dated a number of guys over the years, and when things weren't going real well, we heard about it. I mean, all these different guys she dated, we heard a lot of, oh, he's driving me crazy, he won't do this, and all of this kind of stuff. Well, she's dating this guy named Jeff, and it's really, really weird because we're not hearing anything. We're not hearing a whole lot of I'm mad at him or he's not treating me well or anything like that. And we got a little bit nervous, to be honest with you. And I'm like, something's going on here. Well, then we actually eventually met Jeff. And I realized that my daughter finally had set her sights much, much higher. Just a different kind of person. He was somebody that definitely they connected, and it was real obvious to see that. and it was kind of fun. And everybody that knows you guys now, you can see the interplay and the comfort that you guys have with each other. And so that was a really neat thing to see. But we still didn't know how far this was going to go until came that moment when I just knew he was the right man. He was the guy that was going to marry my daughter.
Aww.
And it happened on my pontoon boat. I have a pontoon boat, and I love my pontoon boat. And the reason I love my pontoon boat isn't because it's a really neat boat. I mean, it's a pontoon boat, for goodness sakes. It just floats. It's great. The reason I love my pontoon boat is because it's one of the only places in the world where I can go where my three daughters, Michelle, Joanne, and Pat, two daughters and wife, are in full agreement that I'm the captain. And whatever I say goes. So that's why I love my pontoon boat.
Spend some time together. Second is my dad's boat. Jeff got into water skiing while I was in college. Dad bought his boat in May 2010, which was the year I graduated. I was home that summer, Jeff was home that summer, because he was still in high school. So we slalom skied almost every other morning, all summer long. My mom would go out with us and just let us do what we wanted to do. We had so much fun, and it's turned into still a lot of fun now that we have our families and stuff. We spend a lot of time out there. But it started with slalom skiing, and it's gotten into barefooting and surfing now. But, yeah, it's when I got home from college and started skiing with Jeff. He was a lot better than me. And that was also like the first time I really looked at him and was like, how am I ever going to catch you with this? And he's still better than me today. Third, snowmobiling. So, Jeff had gone snowmobiling growing up, but it kind of started, I was home on college break, and Jeff was in high school and middle school, and the Green Bay area got a huge snowfall, and we always snowmobiled around the town growing up. So it was like the snowstorm was on a Monday. They called me, they're like, hey, if you can get up here, go. You just gotta find someone to ride with. But everyone had to work. Mom and Dad had to work. Jared didn't really care much for snowmobiling, so it's like, Jeff, get your stuff together, we're going. And I figured out that weekend, or that week, that he could keep up with me on a snowmobile. Now that we're adults and have jobs, we have our own snowmobiles now. And, you know, we're always looking forward to the next trip. And it's nice that a lot of people really don't always like all the drive time going up north and back. But I don't mind it at all. You know, Jeff and I in the truck just talking about everything from investments to, you know, how to spend our money and on the next toys we're going to buy. I mean, I'm pretty sure we have the next couple trucks picked out. And, yeah, so it gets interesting. Lastly, in 2012, Laura and I bought a house. And on that house we had a deck out back, and on that deck is a hot tub. And Jeff and I try to do a hot tub night at least once a week. And probably over the last 9 years, Jeff's drank about 50 cases of beer. But it's a small price to pay.